plays the game. Red light goes on. Gates have opened now. They're off and racing to the first for the day. And Winifer was the first to leave. Jumped straight to the front from Persistence Time. Bonsignor quickly accelerating, going up, joining the leader. Go Crying went forward. British Bessie is a little handier to them today from Vintage Stock as they'd settle down. They're followed further back. Plays the game. Scintillating is on the rails next. A length and a half to Sentimental Gift. Followed back on the inside, Royal Strata. First black and now dropping across the back of the field is Throwdown as they go through the second crossing, 1600 from home. It's Persistence Time that took up the role of pacemaker, settled in front, going up to the next corner by a length to Bonsignor. G Throwdown's giving its rider a torrid time back there at the tail of the field, is really running its races in patches there. Winifer settled up running third. Go Crying is fourth and Vintage Stock is fifth on the fence. A length to British Bessie. Scintillating is down on the inside with Plays the Game handy. Over on the inside, Royal Strata, Sentimental Gift behind those. Further back in the field to First Black and Throwdown is last of all as they start that march out to the riverside of the course. 1,100 left to go in the first from Ascot, where the leader is Persistence Time by two, Bonsignor. A length and a half away at the 1,000, Winifer. Go Crying is running fourth and Vintage Stock is next on the fence. Three quarters of a length away, British Bessie, a length and a half to Scintillating and Plays the Game together. And then two lengths, Royal Strata, Sentimental Gift is back there as well in the field. And towards the tail end, First Black and Throwdown. Persistence Time, though, pilots them at the 700 mark. Still by a length. Running second now, Winifer, trying to get up on the inside of Persistence Time, who just wanted to shift off the fence a little. Bonsignor third. Go Crying is next on the outside of Vintage Stock, being saved up for a run. British Bessie peeling to the outside and so Plays the Game, searching for runs, Scintillating. Sentimental Gift, Royal Strata further back in the field as heads turn for home. Persistence Time still off the rail, out by three quarters. Winifer keeps coming. Here's British Bessie, Plays the Game at any old odds, is running on down the outside as well. British Bessie nearing the 100, though, surges clear. British Bessie pulling away. Impressive win. Sentimental Gift has got to second on the outside in the shadows of the post, but British Bessie has won from Sentimental Gift, or Winifer, who kicked back right on the line. Made it very tight for second. Plays the Game, a markedly improved run. Scintillating, Persistence Time, First Black next in. Bonsignor, Throwdown, Royal Strata. Vintage Stock didn't fire a shot, and neither for that matter Go Crying, who brings up the rear. Well, British Bessie was a super, super run first up, and has still gone around at 15.63.20 and produced a great turn of acceleration here, this daughter of Dick Turpin, and she has won and won easily. Number eight, British Bessie first, close for second. Sentimental Gift was going to get the nod for second, and Winifer kicked. Plays the Game. Boy, hasn't it improved a little at cricket score odds today. Dramatically improved run, but it's eight, British Bessie, off the back of a slashing first up effort, goes on with it here, second run in to beat six, Sentimental Gift, getting the nod for second ahead of number 13 in Winifer, 8.6.13, two Plays the Game, fourth in 2.17.19. It had been a solidly run race, and a length and three quarters with a short half head being the margins. British Bessie is raced by Neil and Ben Randall, J.H. Randall, S.D. Randall, trained by Sharon Miller, and piloted by Alan Kennedy, a Dick Turpin British version mare, with three wins now from her 17 runs. And that was clearly her most emphatic. Second home, Sentimental Gift by Al Maher from Sentimental Star for Peter's Investments, ridden by William Pike for Grant and Alana Williams. And Winifer third in by Blackfriars out of Sister Patricia for M. Ryman. Also Peter Longworth, trained by Trevor Andrews and ridden by Jade McNaught. Race two, the Sightseeing Pass Australia handicap over 1,000 metres. The next number eight, Mac Roy, is the scratching. The sectional time there is 35.44. 35.44, the sectional. These horses won't be coming back directly to the enclosure, I don't think, at least. Quite a number of them, in fact, have gone straight back to the back parade enclosure. Alan Kennedy, though, he likes the idea of coming back here, albeit I think he's just twigged that that ain't the place to be, not on a hot day like this. And he's high-tailed it back in the other direction. So we'll get down to the yard. We'll catch up with the team there. They might have some guests to join us in the next few moments. All right, we'll try and get down there now and catch up. I don't know whether they're there at this stage. Brittany and Scotty, they're down in the yard, but I don't think too many of the other connections are at this particular point. So we'll take a break from Ascot and return as soon as we have more after that very easy win by British Bessie in the first. Cross the border and into the city. You and I can both get jobs. Finally see what it means to be living. You got a fast car, fast enough so we can fly away. We're gonna make a decision. Live tonight, die this way.